Let's look today at Steve Lukather's solo on I'll Be Over You. It's yet again another brilliant example of his use of phrasing and, you know, his great playing, but always targeting chord tones. And that just makes the solo so interesting. Two solos, of course, in the song. The first one really sounds, you know, very composed, thought out beforehand. It's broadly in a C minor. The first one, I'll put some chords on screen, but you're looking at an F, sort of an F minor on A flat to a G7 sus to G7. E minor on G flat. F sus. Okay, then C minor. B on D. E flat major 7. And then that sort of that run into B flat. So it's a C minor sort of sound. So let's have a look at the solo and see how he's targeting chord tones. Okay, typical Luke of the era, using a very sort of wet sound, lots of distortion, some delay. The first part he's doing, it's all up, sort of based around 14th fret. Again, if you think C minor, you've got your C on your 13th fret on the B string, so sort of the beginning of a C minor scale there. So he's reaching up and hitting the F, so bending up from the E flat up to the F. And the first chord, as we said, is sort of that F minor on an A flat. So he's hitting the root note there. Okay, so bending it up there, bringing it down, and then hitting your D. Now when he goes to the D, the chords go to the G7 sus. To G, so again that he's really following that with the chord tone. So hitting the F, coming down, targeting the D. The D is a fifth degree of that G7. So again, this is really, really interesting in terms of his chord tones. Okay, that one there, moving up C minor scale, but he's targeting E flat. Ending on the C, and on those chords are on the E flat. Hitting the E flat here, the chord is an E flat minor. When he resolves on the C here, we're on the F chord there, and the C is the fifth degree of F. So the whole point is, you know, the chords he's playing over, you know, they're not sort of like a one chord vamp. There's some interest happening there, but his solo there, the way he's phrasing, the way he's weaving the notes between it, sound, you know, it doesn't sound like he's sort of cutting changes, but he's obviously targeting those chord tones so well. Really, really interesting. So from the beginning of that solo, so we did the first part, and then bending up from that A to the B flat, all right, is when he's on that F. It's the end of that F, sort of that F sus, and he's bending up the A to the B flat, which is the third and the sus of the F. So again, it's all chord tones. He's following exactly what's happening with the keyboards, the synth underneath. Okay, so that last run that he's doing there, C minor 7 to a B flat on D, is when he's playing. Okay, so ending on a B flat there, right when he comes to B flat on D here. When he's sliding up to the D, hitting a D here and then bending up, it's really nice phrasing. So okay, when he hits that D is when he's on the E flat major 7. Okay, and that D is the seventh degree of E flat. So again, he's hitting that sort of that upper extension. Again, it sounds like a composed solo, this first one, but it's it's brilliant. How he hits those chord tones and makes it sound so seamless. Again, not that he's cutting changes, it just flows so well. It's a great example. Okay, let's look at the second solo there, which sounds a little bit more improvised. Okay, so the chords here are slightly different. We're still in C minor. We're going to do C minor 7, E major 7. F sus to F. But then we're doing that run up to B flat. Okay, now we're on that B flat. It's more of a B flat to an F on B flat. Okay, then sort of a G minor. Going to a G minor here to F on G. Okay, up to E flat. So still C minor, but again, put the chords on screen so we can have a look. All right, so the first notes of that solo, again, we're in C minor that we're thinking here. Okay, so we're in that sort of vicinity. So starting on that minor third and bending straight up to it from the D. Then targeting the B flat down here, up to C, doing a bend. Okay, while we're hitting. Okay. So again, you're ending up on a C note there, which is when you're on the F, that sort of F sus chord. C, of course, is the fifth degree of F, so it's a chord tone. Again, that today we're not as such looking at the solo, but in terms of learning it, but we're looking at breaking it down to see how he's using it from a chord tone perspective. Okay, now when he's doing that chord run, okay, we have a really nice thing he does in the solo. Okay, so we're sliding up sort of from nowhere to the C, G to F, B flat G, C F, and then bend the C up to the D. And that D is the third, the major third of the chord you've just hit, which is B flat. Fingering wise, it's kind of like an X, it's kind of like a cross, okay? Okay. Now, when he's about to go to the sort of the G minor on B flat, okay, and he's going to a G minor chord again. I'll put the chords on screen. He's moving up, sliding up to G, going up what looks like G minor pentatonic. Okay, adding in this 15th fret, the A there. Bending up from the F to the G again, because you're hitting the G minor chord. You just hit the G minor chord, so he's hitting the root, the tonic G. So just beautiful chord tone. That really sounds like downstrokes to me. Okay. Then he's doing some C minor sort of... we're bending up the G to the A, then hitting your B flat C. Straight back down and bending the F up to a G. And then hitting your C. Then hitting octaves. Then the fifth G. Move down F, B flat. Hit F again and then hit C, B flat, A. Slowly. And that's really at the fade out. So again, we were looking at broadly C minor for the entire solo, but the most interesting thing is the chords, again, not a one chord vamp, sort of more complex, a lot of inversions there, a lot of sort of slash chords. But Steve Lukather just, even when the second solo, which is more, sounds more improvised than the sort of composed first solo, it is all about chord tones and weaving it in with his phrasing that it sounds seamless. It doesn't sound like he's cutting the changes and really, you know, oh, he's gone to a G minor, so he's got to switch positions. He makes it. He lets it flow so beautifully. Really interesting to look at. Hope got something out of that. Good luck. See you next time.